Hello friends, in the previous video we were doing problems on of November-December 2017 paper. I finished four problems, problem number 3, 4, 5, 6 of section A. Now I am taking section B. In this there are three problems in differentiation, we will take that 16, 17, 18. So first problem number 16, if y is equal to 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square, find dy by dx. Did you recognize which rule we have to do? It is to be done by quotient rule. So put u is equal to 1 minus x square numerator and v is equal to denominator 1 plus x square. So du by dx. D by dx of 1 is 0 minus d by dx of 2x square is 2x, and dv by dx, again 1 is a number, its differentiation is 0, differentiation of this is 2x, this is minus 2x and that is plus 2x. Now dy by dx is what we want. This is v into d by dx of u minus u into d by dx of v, whole thing divided by v square. That's all. You write this and then substitute. V 1 plus x square into du by dx minus 2x minus u 1 minus x square into dv by dx, that is 2x, divided by v square 1 plus x square the whole square. You can further simplify it. It is possible minus 2x minus 2x cube minus 2x cube minus 2x minus into minus plus 2x cube divided by 1 plus x square the whole square. This minus 2x cube plus 2x cube gets cancelled. Minus 4x divided by 1 plus x square the whole square. This is the answer. This problem carries 5 marks. All the problems in section B carry 5 marks. Next, problem number 17. Problem number 17. Y is equal to tan inverse x. If y is equal to tan inverse x, tan inverse x, show that 1 plus x square into y2 plus 2xy1 is equal to 0. Show that. Again 5 marks. Here it is successive differentiation. You have to find out y1 and then y2. Y1 is differentiation of y, y2 is differentiation of y1, that is twice you have to differentiate it. Again 5 marks. Y is tan inverse of x. So dy by dx, differentiation of y with respect to x, this is y1, is d by dx of tan inverse of x, that is 1 by 1 plus x square. Next, y2, that is d square y by dx square, that is d by dx of 1 plus x square whole to the power of minus 1. Here it has got power 1. If I shift it to the numerator, it becomes 1 plus x square to the power of minus 1. Now its differentiation will be minus 1 into 1 plus x square whole to the power of minus 1 minus 1, n into x to the power of n minus 1, multiplied by differentiation of 1 plus 2x square, 1 plus x square, that is function of a function. So it will be minus 1, 1 plus x square minus 2 to the power of minus 2, multiplied by 1 plus x square. It can be written as, this will be 2x. 1 is 0, differentiation of 1 is 0, differentiation of x square is 2x. Now this can be written as minus 1 by 1 plus x square into 2x, or this can be written as minus 2x divided by 1 plus x square, 1 plus x square. Now we have to show that 1 plus x square into y2 plus 2x into y1, this we'll have to show that it is equal to 0. So this 1 plus x square will be 1 plus x square only. Y2 we have found out, it is minus into minus 2x divided by 1 plus x square the whole square plus 2x into y1. Y1 is 1 by 1 plus x square. Now this 1 plus x square, 1 plus x square gets cancelled. So what is left? Minus 2x by 1 plus x square plus 2x by 1 plus x square. Now these two get cancelled because this is minus and that is plus. So this is equal to 0. We have shown this is equal to 0. 5 marks for that. Next, if y is equal to secant x to the power of x, 18, problem number 18, 5 marks. See, if you have practice, all these problems can be done within no time. Within 5 minutes you can do one problem, you will get 5 marks. If y is equal to secant x to the power of x, secant x whole to the power of x, find dy by dx. You have to recognize first that this is on logarithmic function, problem in logarithmic function. So what we have to do here, it is given that y is equal to this much, take log both sides. So log of y will be equal to log of secant x whole to the power of x. In logarithmic function, we have to take log on both sides. This has to be brought down. That can be done only by taking log on both sides. Next, log y is equal to x into log of secant x log of secant x. So product rule plus function of a function d by dx of log y, differentiate both sides, is equal to d by dx of x into log of secant x. Differentiation of log y is 1 by y into dy by dx is equal to product rule plus function of a function log of secant x, log of secant x, that is v, into d by dx of x plus x into d by dx of log of secant x. This is function of a function. Now this y can be shifted that side, y into, this is 1, so it will be just log of secant x plus x into log of secant x. If you differentiate, 1 by secant x multiplied by differentiation of secant x, that is secant x tan x. So you can cancel this secant x, you get y into log of secant x plus x tan x. This is the answer. This is dy by dx. So dy by dx is equal to this much. That's the answer, 5 marks for that. Then differentiate sin x with respect to x from first principle. This I already done in section C, problem number 28. That is, if y is equal to sin x, show that dy by dx is equal to cos x by first principle. Then one more problem is this, 29, for 6 marks. Problem number 29. Problem number 29. If y is equal to e to the power of m sin inverse x, e to the power of m sin inverse x, prove that one plus x square, no, one minus x square into y two minus x into y one plus minus m square y is equal to 0. So this is also successive differentiation. So y is equal to e to the power of m sin inverse x. That will be, so dy by dx will be e to the power of m sin inverse x into d by dx of m sin inverse x. So e to the power of m sin inverse x into, this will be m into 1 by root of 1 minus x square. This is y1. So this will be m into e to the power of sine inverse x, m sine inverse x into 1 minus x square whole to the power of half, minus half. I've taken it. Square root of that can be written as 2 to the power of half, and if I shift it to the top, numerator, it becomes minus half. Now, this is to be once again differentiated. This is y1. So, y2, you have to use product rule now. Product rule, m will be m only. E to the power of m sine inverse x means, again e to the power of m sine inverse x into differentiation of that, that will be m divided by root of 1 minus x square. This is the differentiation of this into 1 minus x square whole to the power of minus half plus, now product rule, m into e to the power of m sine inverse x into this will be minus half, means differentiation of this will be minus half minus 1, that is minus 3 by 2 into minus 3 by 2 into 1 minus x square whole to the power of 3 minus 3 by 2 minus 1 minus half, it will be minus 3 by 2 into minus 2x, that is differentiation of 1 minus x square will be minus 2x. So this will be y2 using product rule. So here you have to substitute for this thing, 1 minus x square into y2 is all this, that is m square into m into m square e to the power of m sine inverse x by 1 minus root 1 minus x. This will be 1 minus x square. This will go down, root of 1 minus x square, root of 1 minus x square into minus x square, that is 1 minus root 1 minus x square the whole square. So it will become this thing, minus x into y1. Y1 is m e to the power of m sine inverse x divided by root of 1 minus x square minus m square into y is e to the power of m sine inverse x. Now this will get cancelled. So you are left with m square e to the power of m into sine inverse x divided by 1 only. Now I lift off this. Here I left this into this minus into minus plus 6x divided by 3 into 2, No, this 2 will go. So 3x divided by 1 minus x square to the power of 3 by 2 minus xy1, that is m into e to the power of m sin inverse x into x, this x is there, divided by root of 1 minus x square minus y e to the power of m into sin inverse x m square into that. Now this works out to 3 m square e to the power of m sin inverse x divided by 3x divided by 1 minus x square to the power of 3 by 2 minus, if you add these two, x m e to the power of m sin inverse x divided by 1 minus x square to the power of half plus m square e to the power of m sin inverse x. I think you should have got this 2 somewhere. Very lengthy. Start. There was some mistake. So this is y1. I am repeating it. This is y1. y1, that is dy by dx, is equal to this much. Now y2 will be differentiation of this. This is u, this is v. So 1 minus x square to the power of minus half 1 minus x square whole to the power of half v into du by dx, that is differentiation of this, that will be m into e to the power of m sin inverse x into differentiation of this, that will be m divided by root of, that is 1 minus x square the whole square, 1 minus x square whole to the power of half. Now this and this get cancelled. Minus v into du by dx, u into m into e to the power of m sin inverse x into differentiation of this will be half into 1 minus x square to the power of half into d by dx of this, that is minus 2x, whole thing divided by root of 1 minus x square, 1 minus x square, the whole square. Now, that will give me m square y2 is equal to m square into e to the power of m sin inverse of x minus this two will get cancelled. To the power of half minus one. U into dv. dv by dx. This will be minus half. Minus half. Ah. 2 minus 2x. So, denominator will be 1 minus x square, is root and square will go, minus mx into e to the power of m sin inverse x divided by 1 minus x square whole to the power of half. Now, when you substitute this here, what happens? 1 minus x square, 1 minus x square will go. So, what is left here is m square into e to the power of m into sin inverse x minus mx e to the power of m sin inverse x divided by root of 1 minus x square minus x into y1 will be m into e to the power of m sin inverse x divided by root of 1 minus x square. I think here it will be plus minus plus. This will come. Then minus m square into e to the power of m sin inverse of x divided by, no, that's all, m square e to the power of, this is minus, this is plus, it gets cancelled, this is plus, this is minus, it gets cancelled, so that is equal to 0. So this carries 6 marks.